What's up, gamers? It's me, your dad. Ha ha. Ha ha ha. Playing Bullethead. Do I have to shoot these? Oof. Not on my watch, are you hitting the ground? Dunkasses. Ooh, I know I gotta shoot those guys. So yeah, this is a video game, I guess. I don't know, it's pretty freaking funny how, like, you know, how much of a video game it is. I think about that sometimes, I'm like, haha, this really is that video game that is real. Oh my gosh, this game is so good. Especially with two players, but haha, what's that? What even is a second player? Never even. The notion frankly disgusts me. It's so foreign to me, the notion of a second player in a game, that I'm just repulsed by it on a primal, evolutionary level. It's just so abhorrent to me. It's just, ugh, 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 ugh. So yeah, I'm connecting, of course, every video I have to shit on myself about how I record them. I've connected my Chromebook, my school Chromebook, to my TV, and I am filming my TV with my phone. So you know, bro. Oh god, that's horrifying. Don't kill me, bro. Oh god. Oh Jesus. Look at all these. Oh, that guy. Wow. So yeah, this website was good. It was good back in my day. And it's still good now, so it seems. I don't know, I haven't really played on it too much. But it's Nitrum.com, and they make really great looking 3D free games. This one came out ages ago. I wish they had dates on them, because I'm not sure when this came out. But I do remember playing this often, this particular game, and a bunch of other games like it. But sadly, it seems that they've taken some of the games off. I wanted to do a let's play of a game called Sky Serpents, which is a really cool, like, dragon fighting thing, like, where the whole nature of the game is you are on top of the dragon that you're trying to kill, and I thought that was always really cool. You're, like, soaring through the skies. And the whole aesthetic of the game was just amazing. And, I always found that really great, but it looks like they've taken it off, which is saddening. But yeah, freaking love Nitrum games. All of them are just golden, you know? Just the similar design of all of them is really what holds the whole thing together. Because you got websites like Miniclip, which just like games from everywhere, from all developers. But Nitrum, as a website, is like a game developer, as well as a website. So they all have the same sort of baseline art style. While it does differ from game to game, it's not like anything completely like out of left field on any given game, you know? It's all this sort of cutesy, yet sort of, which can sometimes be gritty, art style that I really like. Just really nostalgic. Anyway, that's my review of Nitrum. Thanks for spending 3 minutes of your life watching my review of Nitrum. Yeah, I really, because, I mean, like, look at this. Like, I'm in a post-apocalyptic sort of scenario here with all these aliens sort of coming around. And I'm like a mesh of human and machine, sure. Actually, no, I'm not at all. I'm like a mesh of a little, like orange, plump little dude with, I don't know why I have this shield so much, but I guess level 1 easy, whatever. Actually, level 2, whatever. Yeah, it's like, god, it's just so nice. Bullethead. I mean, who would think of that? How high do you even have to be to think of something like that, dude? How high do you even have to be? Okay, this guy's threatening me. There we go, he's dead. Another bubble. Perfect. Now I won't die. Oof. We got duels. I don't think there's any really reason not to shoot in this game. I think special power-ups are time-based, not, like, ammo-based, so you can just shoot away, baby. Hell yeah. Man, you know, I wish I had a computer, then I could do cool streamy stuff, you know what I mean? But, you know, I'm just gonna have to rely on my charisma instead of general quality of the video, which is kind of doesn't bode very well for me. Oh, I remember this guy. Oh, god. Oh, god damn. Oof. This is gonna be good. Ooh, ripped right through him. Oh, yeah, baby. This guy, nothing. Oh, god.
Because when you play two-player in this game, it's great. Like, you could donate health, which is a concept in games that you, like, never see, but it's always, like, amazing for two-player games. Where it's like, if your buddy, pretty much Liam and I used to play these games all the time, is like, this is the these are the video games that we grew up with, Nitrum.com, MiniClip.com, primarily Nitrum games. We play Mutiny, Twin Shot, Cave Story, all these great games, which were like made actually for two players. It's not just like they put in another character, another playable character, just for no reason. So yeah, that was great. And in this game, you can donate a life. You could drop a health for another player. And I always thought that was like really a great idea because it adds like communication to the game. Like it was always like it's never like haha whatever you're gonna die. It's like oh okay, you have one health and I have two health. No, it's always like oh you have one health, I have three health. Okay, take one of mine so we're even. It's like that sort of thing. It's really, really interesting gameplay. Oh my god. I could never fathom, like, making a video game. It's just so weird. Even, like, a simple game like this. Like, the art is so great on this. And the controls are simple, but they're responsive. And they mesh well with art. Oh my god. I don't know why I'm sucking this Flash game's dick so hard, but I mean, like, I don't know. It's just fun. It's nostalgic. Because I grew up in the age of free games, free browser games, not whatever, NES, so it's not like haha nostalgia 90s, it's like haha nostalgia. Miniclip.com, there are some pretty great Miniclip.com games. I mean, like, the games that were actually made and licensed by Miniclip were good. Like, the ones that, like, said Miniclip on them, not the ones that they just pulled from, like, other sites and stuff and other devs. Like, there was this really great, like, fighting game where you walk left to right and stuff, which I usually do not like beat-em-ups like that, but I did dig this game when I was a kid, where it's like you're a robot or something, and I don't know, I think it's purely in nostalgia, that must be it. I'm sorry, there's no way to analyze these awful games. It's just nostalgia, there you have it. These ones you have to get to the side, because that's the most, that's the best way to hit them consistently. But yeah, I think maybe they put too much of those force fields in this game. I mean, I've been getting off. You know what I mean? Like, here's another, you know, so I'm good. I can just jump into these guys, actually. I don't even have to shoot. And the soundtrack is great, too. Sounds kind of shitty through my TV, but, you know, use your imagination. I should have played other whatever it's called, Nitrum games in this video, but I guess I'm just hooked on this. After this level, video's over, guys. As you can see, by the time limit left on the video. XD. Ha ha ha. Ha ha ha. Ha ha ha. Oh, another Spyro. Good, 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 good. And now for some silence while I collect my thoughts. Oh god, I wish I could play Sky Serpent, man. Oh my god, that would be so nice. But it's not too big. Probably some better games. After this, I'm gonna maybe start. Oh my god, these bloppies. These bloppy floppies. These floppy bloppies. I hate them. Why do they glow up? It doesn't make any sense that they should blow up, but. Oh my god. I mean, like. You know? It's like they're not, like, full of gasoline, like these things. Those things don't blow up, these things just fall into pieces. But the frickin' squishy organic material does blow up. Fancy frickin' that. Fancy that. Fancy that. We done? Is that it? Okay, well, thanks guys for watching this 10-minute video of me playing a Let's Play. Bye.